Write a formula for the nth term of the geometric sequences. And the first one we have is 8, 12, 18, 27, and so on. Well, the general form for the nth term, that is a sub n, is the first term, denoted a sub 1, multiplied by the ratio between each term raised to the n minus 1. And the reason it's n minus 1 we'll talk about in just a little bit. But first of all, let's find what r is. The ratio in general is the ratio of a of n plus 1, or that is one of the terms, divided by the term immediately before it. So for example, in our example, r equals, let's just take the first two terms, one of the terms divided by the one right before it. So 12 divided by 8, or that simplifies as 3 over 2. Okay, so we have our ratio of 3 over 2, and we have that the first term is 8. And then we can just take that information and just plug it right in, and we have a sub n, the nth term, equals 8 times, I'll put times here, 3 halves raised to the n minus 1. And that's it. That's the formula for the nth term of this geometric sequence. Now, the reason we're doing this n minus 1, it has nothing to do with it being a fraction or anything. It's always going to be of this form. The reason is because if we were to type, put in n equals 1, then we want to get that first term. So, for example, if we put in n equals 1 here, we'd have 1 minus 1, and anything raised to the 0 power is just 1. So let's just do a little example here. When n equals 1, that is a sub 1 should equal 8. Let's see what happens. 8 times this 3 halves raised to the 1 minus 1, because I'm plugging the 1 in for n there. And yeah, that's 8 times 3 halves to the 0 power, which equals 8 times 1 equals 8. And that checks out good. That's what we're looking for. So that's why we have the n minus 1. But whether or not there's the procedural understanding and there's the conceptual understanding, as long as you have the procedural, that's good. The conceptual is a bonus. So now we have this this formula, general formula. Let's apply it to the second example, where we go 3, negative 6, 12, negative 24, and so on. Seems like we're going back and forth between negatives, so it gives you a clue that our ratio will probably be negative. Let's see. Let's go negative 6 divided by 3, and yeah, our ratio is negative 2. And by the way, this is assuming if the sequence is written correctly, you should be able to do this ratio between any two adjacent terms. So negative 24 divided by 12, or 12 divided by negative 6, and so on. So we have our ratio of negative 2. A sub 1 is 3. So I'm going to write this general form. A sub n equals 3 multiplied by, this is very important, the negative 2 has to be in parentheses. Negative 2 raised to the n minus 1. That is the nth term of the second geometric sequence. That's the formula for that. Now, I said it's very important that this negative 2 is in parentheses, and the reason is because if you just have something like negative 2 squared, that equals the opposite of 2 squared. Let me put this, denote this with a completely different color. This is a separate, just a separate explanation here. And that would be negative 4. But if you have negative 2 in parentheses, that equals negative 2 times negative 2, and negative times a negative is a positive 4. So that's why it's really important that we have the negative in parentheses, because, you know, we do get to positive on some of these terms. In fact, the next term would be negative 24 times negative 2 would be positive 48, and so on. Okay, so that was just, this is just a little explanation. This is not part of the either one of the problems, A or B. All right, that's the formula for the nth term of the geometric sequence.